had a blast. This is my first session there, and so I'm just getting to know what's going on. And I've just been, it's been a good time, and meeting lots of new people, and lots of opportunities for education. Everyone wants to educate me on their issue. I got the privilege of being on three different committees: roads and transportation, which is the biggest one. There's a committee for government reduction and interstate and international cooperation. And we only have one bill so far on the interstate and international one. In the government reduction, I haven't seen anything yet. I think that's one issue before. So we'll see what happens with a few bills that I've authored. I'll tell you about just a few of them. I presented one in the education committee this week about training teachers to be better prepared to deal with kids with disabilities and trying to bring them out of special ed and bring them into the classroom and how we can deal with that. And I didn't pass out of committee. We're still talking about that one and seeing if, you know, what we can do with that one. So that's been an interesting conversation there. Another bill that I'm a co-author on that I really like is sales tax exemption for bullion or currency. So if you have gold coins, which, you know, may have at one time been currency, if you're buying those, right now you have to pay sales tax on it, even though it's a coin. And so we're trying to exempt that. So Representative Beimer is the author on that one, and I'm glad to be a co-author on it. Another bill that I authored, there's a fellow up here in Syracuse that's a car wholesaler, and he's been doing it for 30 years. And last year they just stripped the whole licensing. You can't be a car wholesaler in Indiana. And so I put a bill in to reverse that and see if we can fix that so he can stay in business. The bill now says, or the law now says, he has to become a retailer. And so we got to see if we can get that through.